knows when society will be...
How's my favourite test flyer?
Again, Mr. Weeks. I set a new record at the South Course.
Fantastic! Your broom performed well then?
The best upgrade yet. It flew beautifully, incredibly nimble. But with the speeds it now reaches, I can feel the wind catching beneath the seat a bit, preventing it from reaching its full potential.
Of course! Should have anticipated that. Exactly the kind of report I've come to expect from you. At last, I think I know what needs to be done for my final upgrade.
What will you do after the final upgrade is complete?
I aim to make Spintwitches the most sought-after shop in Hogsmeade. And I wouldn't mind getting back on a broom myself, just for the thrill of it. Couldn't be more pleased we made headway with the upgrades. Proved the naysayers wrong. Made all the hard work worth it.
I shall look forward to speaking again.
I'll be sure to send you an owl when I'm finished. Thank you again for your help. Couldn't have done this without you. What are we looking for today? Thanks for stopping by. Hope to see you again.
Good for Mr. Weeks. Mr. Weeks and I do make a good team.
Come in! Sorry if there's a smell. New batch of toad hide. You could never go wrong with those. Good choice, I'd say. I'll not mind seeing you here again. Consider yourself welcome.
I got my heirloom back, and I'm able to look...
Hello. Nice to see you again.
You as well. What can I help you with?
What do you have for sale?
What can I help you with today? Thank you for your patronage. Glad you were able to stop by.
Revelio. I should investigate.
Never trust a man who looks too smart. That's what my mother always said.
Are you ready to put an end to Harlow?
I'm ready to do what's needed to take Harlow down. I know you have a plan.
We must gather information from the friends of Mr. Bickle that Archie and Mrs. Bickle mentioned. Agabus Filbert, Otto Dibble, and Mr. and Mrs. Webb.
All right.
I suggest that you speak with each of them while I head to the Hogshead. I saw some Ashwinders heading there. And as my mother would never go near the Hogshead, she is less likely to learn of my activities than if I were to wander the village questioning its residents.
Where am I to find these friends of his?
I do not know about Mr. Rabe, but his wife, Daisy, is often in Hogsmeade, as is Agabus Filbert. And Otto Dibble, he works at Gladrags, so you will likely find him there.
What sort of information am I trying to gather from these people?
They may know what evidence Mr. Bickle had against Harlow, or they may have evidence of their own. We simply need to know whatever they know.
Very well. I'll speak with them. See what I can learn.
I knew I could rely on you. We need to know how they are being blackmailed by Rookwood and Harlow. Meet me here after you have spoken with them. Hopefully, by the time you return, I will be able to move a bit more freely.
Mrs. Rabe should be nearby. Oh, Isco, what have I done? Mrs. Rabe, I wondered if I might speak with you about Theophilus Harlow. I'm a friend of the Bickles and I'm trying to gather evidence against him.
Poor Joanna and little Archie. And now Harlow has taken my darling Isco.
What do you mean? Why?
I'm a security guard at Gringotts, and my husband is a curse breaker for them. Harlow approached me about helping him extort my colleagues into giving him treasures from the vaults.
And you declined?
Of course I declined. Repeatedly. I thought they'd given up, until I came home one night and found my husband gone, and a note affixed to my door with a knife. The note stated that I only had a few days to reconsider helping with some banking needs and that my husband would appreciate it if I acted quickly. But the help Harlow wants is help that I cannot give, and my dearest Isco is paying the price.
Why wouldn't Harlow extort your husband?
Isco's job is even more removed from the vaults than mine. He travels the world for the bank, He could do nothing for Harlow. I'm the one in the bank on a daily basis, which evidently makes me an enticing target for blackmail.
Have you helped Harlow since your husband was taken?
No. I'm worried sick about Isco, but he'd never want me to compromise my integrity. I also know that he's extremely clever. That said, I was hoping he would have escaped by now. It makes me concerned as to why he hasn't.
Are you sure the note means that your husband was kidnapped?
What else could it possibly mean? Besides, I came home to find that someone had trampled the daisies in our garden. It may sound silly, but those were Isco's pride and joy. He would never have let that happen.
Thank you, Mrs. Rabe. Knowing the lengths that Harlow will go to is helpful, albeit more than disturbing.
Mr. Bickle was trying to help us, but now he's gone. I don't know what to do.
I shall do all I can to get evidence against Harlow, Mrs. Rabe.
Very well. Here's the note I received. You must be careful as well. Please don't put yourself in danger.
Some evidence worth hanging on to.
Thank you. Oh, I hope it's not too late.
Now to find Mr. Bickle's other two friends. Otto Dibble works at Gladrags. I should check there.
Please tell me you didn't take it. But perhaps it's been here all along.
Mr. Dibble, may I speak with you? It's about Theophilus Harlow.
I've nothing to say about him. May I interest you in a stunning cravat today?
Please, sir, I would like to help. I spoke to Mrs. Bickle.
You know the Bickles? All right. But we must be discreet. Can't have Mr. Hill hearing this.
I know Mr. Hill. He was kind to me the day of the troll attack.
Oh, he's a good man. But even he wouldn't understand about Harlow. It started a few weeks ago. I was distracted, reading a note, when you know who came into the shop. I hid the note behind the counter and offered to help him. He stared at me for a moment, then asked me to check on an order he'd placed. I went into the storeroom to check on what turned out to be a non-existent order. When I returned, he was holding the note.
What was in the note?
It was a note from Rosie Hill, Mr. Hill's daughter. You see, we've been, well, secretly engaged these past 6 months. We haven't told Mr. Hill yet. I dare say he has higher hopes for her. Harlow advised me in no uncertain terms that my relationship with Rosie, not to mention my employment here, depended upon my cooperation.
What did he ask you to do?
It all happened so quickly. In an instant, he took a very expensive scarf from the counter, pocketed it, and smiled. He said, "Your secret is safe as long as I can supply my lady friend with delightful items like this every so often." I've been able to cover for his requests until now with some creative bookkeeping, but I can't keep it out for much longer. I'm terrified to say anything. I could never live without Rosie.
Could you give me a bit more detail about the note that might help me to identify it should I come across it?
It's on Rosie's special pink stationery. It has her monogram at the top, RH. That's how Mr. Hill would know it was real.
What have you been doing to keep the extortion a secret?
Well, as I mentioned, creative bookkeeping. And I've also been trying to cover the costs with my own savings, but I'm running out of money. Of course, none of this bodes well for my efforts to improve my circumstances and be worthy of Rosie.
I met Mr. Hill the day of the troll attack. He was kind to me. Why don't you just tell him?
He's a lovely man. But when it comes to Rosie, I fear he loses all perspective. He'd see this as a grave betrayal. I'd lose my job instantly, and Rosie as well.
Thank you for telling me. I'm gathering evidence to take Harlow down.
I would love nothing more than to see him rotting in Azkaban, but be careful. He's an awful man and incredibly dangerous. As for Rose's letter, should you happen upon it, I have committed it to memory. You may destroy it immediately.
Understood.
Now hurry off before Mr. Hill returns. Where was I?
We're on the right track. Now to find the last of Mr. Bickle's friends. Agabus Filbert must be around here somewhere.
Revelio.
Hello there.
Alohomora.
Excuse me, Mr. Filbert. I wondered if I might speak with you about your dealings with Theophilus Harlow. I hope to ease Mrs. Bickle's mind by gathering evidence against him.
Oh, tragic. What happened to Bickle? He wanted me to speak out against Harlow for an act of violence committed against me. But I feared Harlow's retaliation, and so I refused.
If you had spoken out against him as Mr. Bickle asked, perhaps Harlow would be locked away by now.
Perhaps. But perhaps I would have suffered a similar fate.
You said that Harlow committed an act of violence against you. Could you tell me what happened?
Before my extraordinary wife, Dulcibella, passed away, she had just completed a small book of poetry. As a surprise for her birthday, one she never had the chance to celebrate, I had the book beautifully bound and plated in gold. One day, Harlow came calling to punish me for having spoken out against the Neanderthals that comprise Rookwood's lot. Before I knew it, I'd been petrified, and Harlow was rifling through my home. He found the book of poetry, with its exquisite gold plating. I watched helplessly, lying there in my entranceway as he walked away with the book, laughing as he went. I was shaken to my core. Still am, to be honest.
I imagine you fear Harlow retaliating again. But do you mind if I share this information with Officer Singer?
I suppose I have no choice. This extortion can't go on forever. You can pass it on to anyone who may be willing to help. Harlow does not like people talking, as you already know.
I've spoken with Mr. Bickle's friends. Now to find Natty.
Revelio.
Like Natty to be late. She said she was going to the Hogshead. Perhaps I'll find her there.
Revelio.
Let's look at what we have, shall we?
Natty must be around here somewhere. Natty's wand. She can cast without it. She wanted me to find this. She's in trouble. Revelio will show me where she was taken.
Nosy little students get what's coming to them.
My first employment.
Natty must have been taken this way. I need to find her quickly. Prince led to this room. There must be another way forward. The hidden door.
Revelio.
Natty must have been taken this way. I need to find her quickly. Scene.
What?
Revelia.
We should speak to her again. Perhaps she'll tell us where we can find that friend of hers.
Ah, she's determined to say nothing. The boss will deal with her.
Book of poems that was taken from Agabus Filbert. He'll be thrilled to have this back. Otto Dibble's love letter from Rosie. He wanted me to destroy this if I found it.
Revelia!
He must be here somewhere.
You found us. I knew you would realize I had left my wand for you. Speak to Mr. Rabe. He will tell you what you need to do.
Revelio. Mr. Rabe? Daisy told me you'd been abducted.
You spoke with my wife. How is she?
Worried about you. Are you all right?
I am all right. Thank you for coming. These locks are cursed, and there's an anti-apparition jinx on the cells. Even Natty's skill with wandless magic cannot free us. I need you to find my wand.
Mr. Rabe, I found your wand.
Well done. I knew it was nearby. Now, you best stand back. One never knows how a curse will react to being broken.
Revelio.
Thank you, Mr. Isco.
My pleasure. And thank you, my friend. We owe our lives to your bravery. I may be too weak to disapparate with you both, but I can try.
You go ahead. Find Officer Singer. We will get out of here on our own.
Very well. But be careful. Thank you, my young friend.
Be prepared for a fight.
Revelio.
These Ashwinders must pay. Let's find Officer Singer and put an end to Harlow once and for all.
Natsai Onai, I should have known. And you, the troll dispatcher. Oh, thank goodness the two of you are safe. Isko Rabe told me a couple of students had rescued him. Should have known it was you two.
Is Mr. Rabe all right?
He is. I sent him home to his wife. Miss Onai, your mother will not be pleased to learn that you're still risking your safety pursuing these dangerous men.
Actually, Officer Singer, Natty and I learned of several Hogsmeade residents who've had their lives threatened by the Ashwinders. In addition to abducting Mr. Rabe to blackmail his wife and Natty, Rookwood and Harlow have also extorted Agabus Filbert and Otto Dibble.
I will look into all of that. As for the two of you, I appreciate what you're trying to do, but you are taking great risk. Next time, please let the authorities handle the Ashwinders.
With all due respect, officer, the authorities haven't done much about any of this.
There's more to taking down an organization like the Ashwinders than simply storming in and hauling them off based on a few accusations. I must insist that you leave them to us. We shall have no further discussion on this. Natsai, you may wish to speak with your mother about this before I do.
My mother will not like this. Thank you again for rescuing me. We shall speak soon.
Truly awed by what we've accomplished. The final broom upgrade is better than even I expected. Stop by Spintwitch's when you can.
Revelio.
The Ashwinders have ceased pestering me. I suspect that's your doing. Thank you from me and Rosie both. We're just leaving for our honeymoon, after we tell Mr. Hill of our recent marriage. Wish me luck.
Oh, hello again. Couldn't have perfected the broom upgrades without your help. As always, I have a special prize for you. I truly enjoyed working with you. Thank you for believing in me. Thanks for stopping by. Hope to see you again.
Take your time looking about. Plenty of wonderful books to stoke a curious mind like yours.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide.
Revelio.
I'm most pleased to be included.
Wasn't too difficult. Too difficult. too difficult. Brilliant! Revelio.
Ah, I have been meaning to speak with you.
I still can't believe we escaped the Ashwinders.
You may not realize it, but you are the talk of the school since you saved me that day.
I wonder how everyone knows about it.
I told my mother in the hope that she would be more forgiving of what I have been up to if it came from me. She likely told other professors, and news travels quickly. Unfortunately, she might, in fact, have been even less forgiving than I'd hoped.
If she knew more about what you've done, I suspect she'd be proud.
If she knew any more about what I've done, she would never let me out of her sight
again. I'm sorry. Has Officer Singer done anything with the evidence we provided?
She has not. Harlow is as strong as ever. Someone needs to stop him, whether it is us or Officer Singer. If someone had stopped the monsters like him in Matabililand, my father would be alive today.
What exactly happened to your father?
It was a beautiful day. My mother had gone to tend to a neighbor who was ill, and so my father and I were galloping in the savannah.
Galloping? Your father was also an animagus, I take it?
He could become the most majestic giraffe. And he would carry me on his back, my arms around his neck. We were on our way home when we surprised a group of bandits who had come from our village. One of them saw me just as he removed a scarf from his face. He shouted and then aimed his rifle.
He didn't want you to identify him.
Exactly. In an instant, my father bowed his neck to protect me and was hit. As he fell, my father changed back into his human form. When the bandits saw this, they turned and ran in fear. Magic terrified them, and then he was gone. And it was all my fault.
Your fault? How so?
He died protecting me. If I had been capable of protecting myself, he would still be alive today. My mother and I tried to go on without him, but it became too much for us there. A few years later, we left to come to Scotland.
Do you think taking down the Ashwinders will avenge your father's death?
No. Vengeance is not what drives me. My father would not want that. He and my mother raised me to believe that it is a privilege to be able to fight for those who cannot. I know there is risk involved, but I feel it is worth it. I am glad you seem to think so too.
What does your mother think about all of this?
Well, as you saw, she worries a great deal. She is an excellent seer, but I think it bothers her to this day that she did not see my father's death coming. She misses him, as do I. So I believe on some level she understands my need to seek justice in a small way, but that does not mean that she likes it.
Do you think your father would approve of the things we've been doing?
Oh my, that is a good question. In theory, yes. Although he would worry, as my mother does. But I think he, of all people, would understand my persistence. My father never shied away from a fight for good, no matter how ruthless the foe. And I think he would have enjoyed knowing that I had a compatriot like you.
I'm sorry, Natty. I can't imagine what you've been through. Your father sounds exceptional.
He was. Truly extraordinary. And thank you for your kind words. We all have our burdens. My father had a saying about that.
Yes, I remember. Rain does not fall on one roof alone.
Exactly. Soon you and I will put an end to the Ashwinders, beginning with Harlow. And once he is gone, we will turn our attention to Rookwood. We are making progress, and we will succeed. Thank you again for saving me. You deserve all of the praise you have received.
Revelio.
can do this. I can do this. They will want to help.
Is this where we're meeting the Centaurs?
Well, they don't exactly know we're coming, so it's less of a meeting and more of a surprise, I suppose.
I'm not sure about this. I can't imagine they're fond of being surprised.
We don't have a choice if we want to help the Snidgets. Perhaps they'll be able to tell that we're sincere. There's something about them that's so knowing. It's almost unnerving.
I suppose they are known for having an air of omniscience.
That's exactly the right word. I just... never mind.
What is it?
It's nothing, truly. We've no secrets to hide.
That's right. We'll simply be honest with them about what we're trying to do. They'll have to help us, won't they?
Yes, of course. You're absolutely right. We'll meet with them, tell them about the Snidgets, and I'm sure to all be fine.
What do you think you're doing here, humans?
Please! We were hoping to speak with you.
Ah! I suppose you'd like a tale for your friends of the time you spoke to a centaur, and it spoke back.
No! Never! We're here because we need your help.
Enough! You made a grave error in judgment in coming here, little witch.
Leave them be, Alec. We do not harm the young. It is not our way.
You forget your place, old fool. I'm the leader of this herd, and while you cling to our way, their kind continue to slaughter beasts like us without a care.
From what I can see, they have slaughtered no one. They will leave here unharmed.
Mark my words, Doran. If I ever see them again, it will be all three of your heads.
Foolish children. Do you know what happens to wizards who wander here? Now, follow me before
Golden Snidgets are still alive, and the poachers are after them. They know that the key to finding them lies in the moonlight, but they don't know what that means, yet. Please, help us find the Snidgets before the poachers do.
Could it be? In the south, there is a cave within which lies what the poachers seek, a moonstone. Retrieve it and place it in the henge in the forest. I, on the other hand, must go speak with the herd. Find me after you have done this.
I don't understand. So the moonlight mentioned in the journal doesn't refer to actual moonlight, but to a moonstone. What do moonstones have to do with Snidgets? And why was he so certain about where we could find one?
Isn't moonstone all around us? Why retrieve one from a cave?
Knowing centaurs, I suspect he's referring to a specific moonstone. We'll likely know it when we see it.
I don't know, but I am inclined to believe him, what with his being a centaur and all.
I am too. It is a shame how quickly he left. What was his name? Doran.
That's what the leader of the herd called him.
Well, if Doran knows something we don't, I'd rather act now and ask questions later. I can head to the library and start looking into the cave he mentioned. I'll let you know what I find.
Revelio.
I hate to see a creature get put down like that, but trolls have no business in...
Abandoned long ago, no doubt. Revelio! This could prove dangerous if I'm not careful.
Since you've all turned yourselves into a pack of jarvis. Levioso! Levioso! Levioso!
Revelio. I should investigate. Revelio. These rocks have seen better days.
Levioso! Levioso!
Levioso!
Confringo!
Revelio!
Confringo!
Incendio!
Confringo!
Revelio!
Incendio!
Revelio. Revelio.
This looks intriguing.
Incendio! Revelio. Revelio.
brain been infested with Bundemans? A maneuver like that could have gone.
Yeah.
This could prove dangerous if I'm not careful.
Incendio!
Revelio.
Revelio.
Revelio. Leviosa. Revelio. Revelio.
I wouldn't go back to Pit upon Ford if they was giving out gallons.
Mr. Talus.
Try.
You're the one who stole our goblin. Well, their goblin helped, but then it was ours.
Chris! Sender!
You've made a great mistake.
Shame nobody saw that. Revelio. Revelio. What do you have in store for me this time? Revelio.
Deke thinks you should be proud of all the potions you've brewed.
nice to see you, my young friend. Revelio.
Aren't you one of the students who saved little Archie Bickle from...
Hello, Mr. Semi.
What can I do for you?
What do you have for sale?
What can I help you with today? Aren't you the student who ran all those goblin loyalists off? I can't tell you what a relief that was to everyone in Lower Hogsfield. I hope to see you again sometime.
Revelio. I should investigate. Revelio.
Let's see what's up your sleeve this time, Merlin.
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Merlin himself would be proud.
Revelio. Revelio. intriguing.
Revelio! Confringo! Bombarda! Revelio! Revelio. Revelio. Arresto Momentum. Confringo.
Been quite stately in its time.
Incendio! Revelio! Revelio. Incendio. Revelio. Confringo. Incendio. Incendio. Revelio.
Who lived here, I wonder? Boomer didn't have an audience for that one. Revelio. 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 Accio. Revelio. I know what that means. Merlin trial.
I tell you this, Hogwarts is lucky they've got protection charge.
Who's so tricky after all, man?
Sometimes I do wonder if your eyes are still in your head.
Thank you. Revelio.
Irondale's not half as tough as it sounds.
Lumos.
Thinking in terms of good and evil merely indicates a limited imagination, in my opinion.
Crucio! Bees around here can sleep a bit easier now. Revelio. Lumos. Alohomora. Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. This could prove dangerous if I'm not careful. Revelio. I should investigate. Revelio. Confringo! Bombarda! Revelio! Is there something I can help you with, Mr...
Adley? Edgar Adley? No, I don't think so. Blast Milo and his mad schemes.
Milo?
He was my friend. Came to me a few days ago with a brilliant plan to make some quick galleons. All I had to do was follow him into the Forbidden Forest. Had I known he wanted to procure venom from a living acromantula. Oh, poor Milo. He didn't deserve to go like that.
I'm very sorry to hear about your friend.
Oh, thank you. I can't think of it. Milo's body is still in that cave with the absconder.
The absconder?
Aye, Milo's name for the acromantula. He did have a flair for the dramatic. In fact, as he died, Milo begged me to take his heirloom pocket watch, so that his daughter would have something to remember him by. But I fled.
Why would someone risk their life for spider venom?
As a potion ingredient, acromantula venom is incredibly valuable. In large part because it is, as poor Milo has proven, impossible to get from a live acromantula.
If I have time, I can try to collect the heirloom watch, Mr. Adley.
You can't possibly go to the acromantula's cave. You'd be killed. Please, forget I said anything.
Beedle the Bard still ring true today.
Can't imagine.
Could you please remind me what you needed help with?
My friend Milo and I went to an acromantula's cave, hoping to harvest its venom. It didn't go well. I barely escaped. Milo wasn't so lucky. I'm hoping someone can retrieve an heirloom from Milo's body to give to his little girl.
How ourselves a Wizardkind's best.
Revelio!
If anyone ever knew how to keep Muggle down.
Seems a pleasant enough little place. Alohomora. Revelio. Alohomora. Mine now, Demigod Revelio. Could it be a Merlin trial? Revelio. 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 Himself would be proud. Revelio. Revelio.
It's one thing to see.
You can read a thing.
The cave must be somewhere in this maze. I wonder what else is in here.
Take it. Revelio. This could be the Acromantula cave Mr. Adler mentioned. Revelio. Find the heirloom for Milo's daughter. Revelio. Confringo. Revelio. I need to bring this heirloom back to Mr. Adley.
Ah, you look none the worse for wear. Oh, I take it you decided against entering the Absconder's cave, then.
Mr. Adley, I retrieved the heirloom pocket watch from Milo's body.
Merlin's beard! How did you? Actually, I don't want to know. I don't want to think about that Acromantula ever again. Thank you. Thank you very much.
I'm glad Milo's daughter will have something to remember him by.
I am too. As far-fetched as his schemes were, Milo was a good friend, and I shall miss him. Please, accept this reward for your trouble.
What do you have for sale?
Milo can rest in peace now that his wishes have been fulfilled and his daughter has something to remember him by. Never mind replenishing my stocks. Pleasure doing business with you. Thank you for stopping by. I appreciate your business.
Alohomora. This looks intriguing. Revelio. Here's a pleasant surprise. Revelio.
Hey, for your information, I received an owl from her just the other day. And as for her affection, it is well and bountiful.
Hello? There's a voice coming from that well.
You owe me galleons and you can't pay.
Who's there? Stop! Out as a troll you are!
No. Impressed.
Petrific has touched
that! We had plans for that infantry. Where's that?
Petrific has touched that!
Ah! How did I like Petrific?
Petrific has touched that! Damn you! Petrificus
Totalis! You may be more skilled.
Petrificus Totalis! Accio! Petrificus Totalis! Petrificus Totalis!
Revelio.
I know yet. I.
Right. Expulsion!
Trolls, best word.
Quite conductive, aren't we?
Explosive! No!
Let's play, shall we?
Expulsion!
I quit.
Flash of inspiration.
You took Nora Treadwell from us.
Expulsion!
You're the one who freed our hippogriff.
Pick the one who took the goblin out. Expulsion!
Come.
Might want to look up.
Expulsion! There'll be more of that. Quite a violent streak.
Expulsion!
Expelliarmus? Afraid?
Death from above!
Expulsion! That'll be very agile. You're done thinning our ranks.
Expulsion!
Dark magic, eh?
What have you done?
Oh, this is expulsion!
Incendio! Nobody will believe
Velio.
Can you help me?
Is someone down there?
Down there? Oh, beg your pardon. I'm here. There's no one here but me. Some thoughtless wretch casually tossed a bit of parchment into me and it caught. If you could please take it.
Seems to be some sort of map.
Thank you. Oh, thank you. What a relief. I hope the map serves you well. At least better than it did me.
Revelio.
Like a place right out of a storybook. Mr. Adley, do you have a moment?
For you? Always. You're a hero around here.
What do you have for sale?
Anything I can help you find?
Thank you for stopping by.
Revelio.